Welcome back to my blogs. As I'm waiting for parts for the tape and the rubbers, if I do buy the rubbers, I decided should have put these on when I put on the brakes, the mud guards, but I'll put them on quickly. They only take very short, it's not very hard. Quick thing on how to do it. All we gotta do is take off this nut back here in the back of the brake and put this on, and then adjust these two down to these two front ones. So it's three nuts. Doesn't take very long. And so I'm just gonna go at it quickly. Got the wrong one. Just whip this off quickly. Wrong one again. My lucky day. So we're just going to take this nut off. This has one of those plastic cups in it to self-lock. So you can't just wind it off with your fingers. There she goes. In goes the guard here. The two nice straightened out stays, which I showed you how we did that. Most I put the washer on this side of it. Now that I dropped it, of course, when you want to find it, you can't. Unbelievable, it's fallen here somewhere. And you look and you can't find it. You guys are staring at an empty screen. There we go. Washer back on. And nut. That'll be the top of the mud guard now. On. Everything needs a little adjusting later on anyways when I get the brakes on. So we'll just tighten this up. It's all ready to go then. Bike is getting close to finishing. There we go. There's the first bit of the mud guard. I have to adjust the stays here. Just got to remove this bolt here. And then the stay will come up in there when I loosen it out from the other end, which maybe I can pan and show you. Where's the other end here? Right there. See how much is sticking down? Well, that's because I tighten this whole thing up. There she is, she's loose. So the stay, pretty stubborn stay. Stay comes forward into this, right? There we go. Maybe my gloves are breaking up here. So we just put this in here. I might find a little bit cleaner nut later on, but there we go. Give it a little squeeze. Oh, you can't see me at the moment. I'm over here again. Isn't that great? Right. That's the squeeze. And now I'm going to go back down to that piece and just tighten this up for the time being. We'll adjust them later on. It's got to be off the wheel a bit. Even a slight squeeze is a good idea. There we go. And now I'm basically going to do the same over the other side with this other side. I'm going to screw it on. And the back is exactly the same. It goes on the back nut and then the two screws up to the side. So just complete that and then I'll show it to you. Yeah, for the back hub, I had to take out the wheel because there's this nut and bolt right down in here and I can't get at it otherwise. And so that's the way I'm going to have to do this. So I'm going to poke the guard through the top of the brake. And then it's going to come down. And see, that screw hole is going to go right in there. See it? And right in there is the screw, which was hard to get at. So I'll do that first. I got a Allen screw and put it in from behind. And here's the washer and the nut on it. So that's solid. So now I'm coming up here. If I just move the camera a little, you can see it. Oops, sorry. And there you can see, I just have to take this off and put the bracket on. And then we'll do the bars again. It'll be all set. So that'll be the back one. It's four bars in the back to adjust. Yeah, it's slowly getting a little dark out here. The light's fading. I got the mud guards on. I noticed one of these stays was... There's somebody beeping their horn in the background. What can I say? One of the stays on the back was extra long, and then I realized the two mud guard stays on the front, one's long and one was short, so I just exchanged them. That took me a little while. Adjusting them, getting them nicely set in so that they don't rub right on either side here. The brake's rubbing a little here. So get that off. There we go. Anyways, we have it to this stage. We still have the cables to put in and our purchase. But otherwise, you know, we've come a long way now with the bike, and it's really shaping up to be a beautiful Norco Monterey bike. So, this is the end of the blog for tonight.